Hello everyone and good night. So today's setting is a little different because I'm in the bathroom and the echo is probably gonna bother you guys, so I do apologize in advance. But I'm doing my nighttime skincare routine and I wanna show y'all how I prep for tonight. I'm gonna take off this headband. I attempted to like stretch out my hair today just to see the length and what it all was looking like. My hair is like really, really damaged, but it's almost fall, and in the fall and winter, I like to put a lot of heat in my hair, so I told myself I'm not gonna continue to cut my hair. I honestly just wanna chop it, and I'm thinking about doing a bob on my hair because either way, my hair grows pretty fast. So, I don't know, it's just up in the air for now, but my hair has length, but like I said, it's not healthy, so I wanna get rid of that. So that my hair could grow pretty damn strong. I want to just cut it and start all over again because I'd rather have healthy hair than long hair that does not look good. But when it's straight, you really can't tell. So that's why I'm not so pressed about it. And I'm going to start straightening it out again since, you know, cool weathers are starting to come back. That's what I normally do in the winter / fall. I usually just do a lot of washing sets. I straighten up my hair a lot, which is why I'm in the situation that I am now, because I apply a lot of heat in my hair. And I told myself I wasn't gonna apply heat, but I'll be lying to myself. I'd rather wear my hair straight than to wear a wig. I'm just at that era in my life where I'm embracing my natural beauty. And y'all, my eyelashes look ridiculous, I know. A couple of my videos have been coming on here looking crazy with these eyelashes. I made an appointment with my eyelash tech, so I'm trying to hold on to dear life, but I think I gotta take these off like ASAP. I don't want to continue to put heat in my hair, but at the same time, I wanna be able to wear my hair straightened out. Well, first and foremost, I wanna address something that you all probably been like wondering. I have an allergic reaction. I had like several allergic reactions. I probably had like a good 3 episodes back to back where my face blew up and like my whole face was in a rash. Like it had hives. It itched so bad. The first time I actually did scratch, which is why I have all these dark spots here. The second time around, I noticed that I made my skin bad. So I didn't scratch even though it was an unbearable itch. So apparently I had an allergic reaction several times because I've been using something that I didn't know what I was using that was causing it. And for the longest of time, I thought it was the glycolic acid, but it's not the glycolic acid. I actually think I found out what it was. And this is not certain because I haven't seen an allergenist yet, but I'm pretty almost positive sure that it's this damn SPF that broke me out. So it's funny because the bottle is practically done. I then had to suffer and go through 3 episodes of a severe allergic reaction. When I tell you it was severe, I blew up like a freaking fish. Like I looked like Martin when he got beat up. Like I had to be put on steroids so that my face could the swelling could go down. And I look real bad, like super duper bad. But yeah, I think it's that. We're staying away from that. And everything else I use, it doesn't break on my face. So I'm going to start using the glycolic acid. I had discontinued the glycolic acid because I thought that's what I was allergic to. But like I said, it's not the glycolic acid. I know for a fact because I've already used it recently and I didn't have an allergic reaction. And my face was fine. And that's for up and down that I've been using this plenty of times. And there's been numerous of times where I didn't have a reaction to it. So it's like, why would I react to it one day and not the other? So that's when I was like, no, it's not the glycolic acid. And I'm so happy because I really love the glycolic acid. I feel like it has helped a lot to even my tone, my skin tone. So I'm gonna use it tonight to like even out the dark spots because I'm getting tired of coming on camera and looking like, oh, like a struggle. Like it looks really bad. Yeah, so I'm gonna use the glycolic acid tonight. I'm gonna show y'all. Enough rambling, let's get into the routine. It's a perfect night to do my makeup removal portion of the skincare because I'm wearing makeup. I'm not wearing excessive makeup. I honestly just put contour here, trying to cover the bags under my eyes, but I didn't put foundation all over my face. and I did my eyebrows, and my eyelashes was already like glued on, as I stated, glued on horribly. I need to take them off. It is time.
But
my skin actually is getting so much better. It still looks pretty bad, but it's getting so much better. Like, this used to be so much darker. But let me hurry up because my battery's dying. This is my new way to remove my makeup. Before, I used to use the makeup wipe, so you definitely want to go ahead and use Marcella water. I have my cotton rounds, and yeah. Enough talking, just watch me. My eyelash just came off. I'm excited because they looked horrible. It's always one eyelash that's super stubborn to come off, and that will be my left eye. I don't think I'm gonna be able to take this off tonight. I took the corner part out. She acting all shady, she ain't been calling me baby, yeah. Girl, I'ma stop playing, I'm kidding. But then I call to say, what's up with your day? Mumble in your voice, heard a tremble in your cadence. Every single word seemed to hit a nerve, cause you keep saying, bye bye, eyebrows. For some reason, the eyebrows is always the part of me that I hate taking off. Like, I just feel like it makes my face. Okay, won't you say my name if you... I don't know why I have my hand like this. I be doing some weird stuff when I'm concentrated. So I really am trying to remove this eyelash from my eye because I don't want to have one eyelash on, but it's really glued to my eye. To my eyelid. I'm not even gonna fight it. I'm gonna go ahead and wash my face now with some soap. I like this micellar water and it makes my face feel so smooth. I don't even have to rinse this out, but I know my face is still pretty dirty with makeup. I need a very thorough clean face. So, especially when you're going to use glycolic acid, you want to make sure that you don't have no impurities, because it's going to exfoliate deep in your skin, and that's just going to cause irritation. So you want to go ahead and like thoroughly clean your face when you're using the glycolic acid. Especially if you have sensitive skin like you. So I'm going to use the Clean and Clear. All alone, it ain't nothing. Shady, but trust me, girl, you're my baby. Let's stop playing again. Girls love Beyonce, girls love to fuck with your conscience. Girls hate when niggas gon' miss. And shawty, you ain't no different. These days it's hard to meet women. It's like my love life is finished. I've been avoiding commitment. That's why I'm in this position. I'm scared to let somebody in on this. None of friends, none of love. You get your fair share of admirers that call you fool. You try to act like it's just me, but I am not alone. But if you're alone, then say my name, if no one is around you. Say, baby, I love you, you ain't running games. Say my name, you on the beat. route and the glycolic acid. Now with the glycolic acid, you want to make sure you do not go over your eye areas. Don't do it. I'm gonna shake. It doesn't say shake, but I'm gonna shake anyways. And I'm gonna dab that. And I'm just gonna really, you don't really have to rub this in because it's like really strong. But remember, don't go close to the eye area. But I'm already trying to get rid of these spots, these dark spots, so. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. And no matter how much you clean, your face is never 100% clean. Hopefully that'll humble some of us. So now that I did that, I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my hyaluronic acid 2% from The Ordinary. And this stuff is really, really sticky, the texture, you see that? Very sticky. So, yeah, a little goes a long way, but I'm gonna go ahead and, put this much on my face. I don't know if that's a lot, but. My skin after all of that washing. I really love the texture of this thing because it's like super sticky, but it like feels very hydrating to my skin. You can see the difference already in my skin. It's nice and plumped and hydrated. It definitely gives plump.
Yeah, it does.
DJ, shut up. Now that I did the hyaluronic acid, I'm gonna go in with my CeraVe Eye Repair Cream. And it looks like so. Now, I'll be honest, this is not my favorite eye cream, but, and this is why I'm making it my eye, my nighttime eye cream, until I buy my Tony Moly, what is it called? Tony Moly Retinol Eye Cream. Retinol, anything with retinol for your eyes is super good. I don't think this has retinol in it, though. Does it? No, it does not. Because I do remember reading the ingredients because I thought I was going to be allergic to something that I saw similar in the SPF that I was using that I told you that I'm allergic to. But no, I'm not allergic to this. Thank the Lord. I'm just going to put this under my eyes. Want to massage it in there, but also tap so it can penetrate. Ladies and gentlemen, eye cream is super important. Don't skip it. And don't be cheap on it either. I mean, I don't use super expensive eye creams, but just have something with retinol in it. I highly recommend any eye cream that has retinol. You will definitely see the difference in your eyes. It won't look as tired. Okay, so I finished with my eye cream. And now I'm going to go ahead and top this off with my sunscreen for my job. I like this sunscreen because it reminds me of the Super Goop, which most people don't like because it's very hydrating and it makes your skin look very oily. However, I love having my skin oily when I'm going to bed. Only when I'm going to bed. I like to have a hydrated looking skin because that looks healthy, but when I'm going to bed, I like to look glossy. And wear sunscreen at all times. Not only in your daytime, not only at daytime, but also at night to go to sleep. You want to go ahead and give your skin that extra barrier of SPF before you go to sleep. Your skin will thank you. Trust me. And that's literally all I do for my nighttime routine. Sometimes you'll see me put on my hyaluronic acid mask. My kelp mask. But since I put the regular hyaluronic acid 2%, I'm not gonna put that on. And also, sometimes you will see me put petroleum jelly, Vaseline on my skin, depending on how dry it gets, because there's days where like my skin is screaming for moisture, and then there's days where it's just like normal. This is just normal. So overall, my skin looks nice and healthy. I'm just trying to get rid of the blemishes now. Like, I'm tired of seeing this. So I'm gonna be more consistent with the glycolic acid because it definitely does exfoliate deep in the skin and gets rid of the hyperpigmentation. In the daytime, I would sometimes at night I like to use this, but since I'm running very low, I'm not gonna use it at night. But I love using this Good Molecule Discoloration Correcting Serum. If you haven't tried it, you're missing out. Go ahead and purchase. I need to purchase another bottle, matter of fact, because that's how good it is. And lastly, I'm just going to go ahead and moisturize my lips. And then I'll hop in the shower and put on my robe and go to bed. That is it for my nighttime skincare routine. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see y'all in the next one. Bye.